Good morning.
Flippin' physics.
A continuous charge distribution is a charge that is not a point charge. In other words, a charge which has a shape and electric charge which is continuously distributed throughout the object.
So a continuous charge distribution is just a charge with shape?
Basically, yeah. In order to find the electric field which exists around a continuous charge distribution, we can use the vector form of Coulomb's law and the equation definition of an electric field. Bo, please use those two equations to find the equation for the electric field which surrounds and is caused by a point charge.
I thought you said a continuous charge distribution was not a point charge.
I did. However, in order to determine the electric field which surrounds and is caused by a continuous charge distribution, we need to start with the electric field which surrounds and is caused by a point charge.
Okay. The vector form of Coulomb's law states that the electrostatic force which exists between two point charges equals the Coulomb constant times charge 1 times charge 2 divided by the square of r, the distance between centers of charge of the two charges, all times unit vector r. The equation definition of the electric field is electric field equals electrostatic force divided by charge, where both electric field and electrostatic force are vectors. That means the electric field caused by a point charge equals the Coulomb constant times the charge of the small positive test charge, little q, times the charge of the point charge, big Q, divided by r squared, all divided by little q, and then all times unit vector r. Little q, the charge on the small positive test charge, cancels out, and we get that the equation for the electric field which surrounds and is caused by a point charge equals the Coulomb constant times the charge of the point charge divided by the square of r, the distance between the center of the point charge and the location where we are defining the electric field, all times unit vector r. But I still don't get what this has to do with the electric field caused by a continuous charge distribution.
Thank you, Bo. Hopefully what I'm about to say will clear up those doubts. We're going to consider the charged object to be made up of an infinite number of infinitesimally small point charges, dq, and add up the infinite number of electric fields via superposition.
It's an integral.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Exactly. We now know dE, the electric field caused by every infinitesimally small part of the continuous charge distribution dQ, equals the Coulomb constant times dQ divided by r squared times unit vector r. We can take the integral of both sides, which adds up the electric fields caused by the infinite number of infinitesimally small point charges dQ, and we get the electric field caused by the continuous charge distribution equals the Coulomb constant times the integral of dq over r squared, all times unit vector r. Okay, Bobby, please review the three charge densities.
Sure. Linear charge density, or lowercase lambda, equals charge divided by length, so it's in units of coulombs per meter. Surface charge density, or lowercase sigma, equals charge divided by area, and the units are coulombs per meter squared. And volumetric charge density, or lowercase rho, equals charge divided by volume, and its units are coulombs per meter cubed.
Great. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.